You see here, British pound at the strategy entry level held three times fake breakout. So supposed to be at 67, so though now trading nicely lower and have some dollar strength, managed to not trade well here. And you can see how important this level is. Look for a short here, euro dollar if it breaks below, hold resistance, targeting support one. This is the short euro dollar here, I'd like to short at the pullback as well. As yesterday, perhaps this can go straight down, dollar breaking above yesterday's high. Straight down, scaling out here, we'd like to hold before support one. And see dollar index here up to resistance one. You see here euro dollar on the daily chart, just to see where we are in context. You can see basically a nice area of support is here, which is like another 35 pips lower. Of course, if we break down, I will land here, it comes back up now. So we're entering this zone here on the daily chart, straight downward, and looking for continuation and also support too here. So potentially we hold this and more dollar strengthens. Would be a nice area to hold the trade. Let's go back here and short it again at the same price, scaled out here. We're looking to build a position for a big downside move. Pound here, how good this level was. Now about 50 pips lower. Scale out 66 here, now looking for a new low, scale out before support one. Let's put it back here, we'd like to use this range as a potential resistance for continuation lower. Scale out here and it here was willing to add higher. If this breaks now, we'll see nice downside dollar just at the highs. Let's take the oil here to see what it does at yesterday's low, and if it goes down to support one, we'll like to go long here for 30 cents pounds or so. Price pushing here at the low of the day, let's see if it breaks. Scale down here, add it here, here. Currently, price bouncing and shorting here, taking 5-10 pips until I hold for a further downside. Now, further here, we'll leave one for support one and the rest one to hold it for below support one. Writing the XY here, what it does at resistance one. Major resistance level of the XY is above resistance two up here. So, let's see if it manages to go towards there. Before support one here, let's see what it does. We'd like to give this some time, capture another 15 pips or so. A break below support one and towards this area here, and eventually this low of 2018 of January. So, eventually looking for another 20 pip downside. Why is this? Because eventually. Dollar index strengthened here at the US session. If you remember today's trade, this morning, the pound versus dollar, you can see the level here, 10 pip stop loss, the strategy. Price traded 9 pip against, nicely 50 pip lower, but I managed to make a loss earlier here. So this trade would have been top trade here on pound, but good on euro dollar now. For example, if you see here, we have multiple times resist support here on October 2017, I think it was. Here also. Also, this area generally is an area of resistance, 10 to support, 10 support, support, then broke down. So, of course, you don't want to short tax here unless you are confident to hold another 100 points against you, because it can easily trade. But if you want to locate a trade, this is what you need to do. You need to identify the levels. For example, you can see this level here from 1st of of December 2017. This gold price is at now 12,814 or so. If we switch on 5 minute chart to see what this looks like, and also another level here. So let's switch on 5 minute. So about DAX, yesterday we had a whole day, so DAX was closed here. So what we have today opens, trades straight out of previous day's highs, multi-day high. This is a technical break and a short liquid, short covering. So shorts have been trapped and aggressively covering the position, which creates massive down upside. So we have 240 points up for the day. It's good to find some resistances, but it's better to trade with a trend. DAX will not hesitate to just trend another 100 points, and the bad thing for this is that it will do it slowly, like pound versus the dollar today, which was slowly going higher and higher and higher. And this can be very frustrating to hold short. Unless you're willing to short and you're willing to risk 50 pips or 100 pips. And then you can potentially catch a good downtrend if the US market also goes lower as well, maybe. Or perhaps you can target VWAP here, which, as you can see all day, is just holding above. And I'm sure that the support above the VWAP should be. You can see this level we found on daily here, this area, this range of prices, which is like 30 prices or so, held resistance for now. This is a good trade location, but it's against the trend. Unless you are confident of doing this, you can see now how it failed here at this little range. This is levels from previous daily highs and lows, if you remember a little bit earlier. So Euro dollar can support here. If you see the profile here, we have an open straight up single prints and then distribution of the highs. This is called P-shaped profile because it's like a P-shape basically, which means aggressive upside move or downside move, which is a P-shape, and then consolidation of the highs. Maybe we go short it again here at this area of resistance. Looking to see if dollar can strengthen now, and also would like to see what price will do at this range. Of course, I'm out most part of the trade, but would like to capture another 10-15 pip down of potentially from here. If dollar pull back here and the next tower holds support and comes back up, that was the idea of the additional short trade. Would be interested in Nasdaq here at the strategy level if holds some support, go long here. Let's see. Seem to pull it back now. Let's go back on Euro dollar here, scale it down and just flatten now with the whole trade. Very nice trade up to 76, is down to 54 or so. Good 20 pip of trade here.